Hi there. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how to create this little creature here and also how to do the interesting material that's on it that gives that impression of veins and capillaries beneath the surface. If you're interested in how to distribute it over a landscape like this, then I'll also provide a link to one of my geometry node tutorials that will demonstrate how to do that. So to begin with, I just need to give some thanks to the channel Polyfjord, which demonstrated a very quick and easy way to create a moving creature a bit like this. They did it for a sort of walking crystalline crab type creature. I'm just using some of that to base how to quickly create an animated creature like this. So to begin with, I'm just going to add a mesh plane. This is really just a little cheat because there's no way to add a simple vertex anymore. Go into edit mode, press M with all the vertices selected, and just say merge at center. So we've now got a single vertex. Press E and we'll just go up a ways. I'm going to go to orthographic view and just look straight on, and then E again. And you can do this as many times as you want to get the shape that you're looking for. So that's just created a simple stick that we can use to base the claw of our creature on. And I think what I'm going to do is just push that one out there a little bit, bring that one back to there. I'm just pressing G to do this and maybe extend it one more time. I'm just tending to get them a bit shorter each time. Come out of edit mode, right click, and then go to modifiers, add modifier, and add the skin modifier. Now to begin with, you will get a somewhat odd looking shape, and you need to go into edit mode. Probably best to go into wireframe mode to make sure you can see which vertex you've got selected. Now you can't just simply scale a vertex or even rotate it, but if you use Control A, you can now rescale the skin that's around the vertex. And we're going to smooth this out in a moment anyway. So probably go with something about there. And now I'm going to add another modifier, which is the subdivision surface modifier. And we can go up another level just to get it a bit smoother. Now we can't just right click and say shade smooth at the moment because we haven't got any real surface here. It's a generated surface. So we can click this little button here and that goes to smooth shading and we're ready to move on. But you'll notice there's another little button in here called create armature. So if I go to wireframe and I click this button, we've now got an actual armature in there. And if I select that armature and go to pose mode and then select, say, the end bone, you can see it's already linked into the skin. So that's a very easy way to make an object like this. Under bone constraints, we can add inverse kinematics. And you'll notice as I move this top bone, the whole thing moves in order to accommodate as best as it can the movement of that top bone. If you only want part of the mesh to adjust, then you can reduce the chain length. By zero, it means all the way to the root bone. But if we go up to say one, nothing really happens. If we go to two, you can see there's a little dotted line here now. And you notice only down to that second joint is moving. And then I go up to three, and now the dotted line is there, and now this much is moving, which you might want because this may be joined to the rest of the body, which in fact it is going to be, but I'm going to leave it at zero and we'll let the whole thing move to accommodate. So now I'm just going to come back into object mode and I'm going to add an empty. I'll make it a bit smaller and I will just put it roughly here near, it doesn't have to be completely on top of it, but near the tip of the claw. And then we'll look from above. Again, precision is not required here, and that will do. So now I'll go back to my armature, go back to the bone constraints, and I'm going to set the target to the empty. And you now see it follows that empty around. If I go back to solid view, so we can make that empty move however we want to, and the claw will attempt to continue to point at it. So I'm going to add a UV sphere. I'm going to scale it down, we'll set it to shade smooth, and we'll make it quite a bit smaller. And that's obviously going to be the body of our creature. You can see why you might want to freeze one of the joints here. So now I'm going to select the empty, the armature, and the claw. Shift D to duplicate, rotate Z 180, and then GX just to move it to somewhere about here. I'm going to select all of those again. Shift D, rotate Z 90, and I've got four now. So we've got four different empties, each one controlling their own claw, and we now need to add some movement to this. So I'll bring up a new window and we'll go to the graph editor. I'll select the first of the empties, make sure I'm at the beginning of my animation. Now is a good time to set the animation to whatever length you want to use. I'll leave it at default 250, and I'm going to press I to store the location, and I'm going to do that for each of those empties. Obviously you could do this before you duplicate, but you will then need to reset the start positions, and as it's easy to do, I decided just to copy them first. So we'll go back to that first one, come up to here and press N, and go to modifiers. I'm going to add a modifier which is a noise modifier. So I press play now, you can see that for X location we've got some noise, very fast, small movement noise in there at the moment. So I'm going to increase the scale, which will slow that down a lot, but I'm then going to increase the strength, which will make it obviously move more. I'm then just going to click this little button here to allow me to copy those settings, and then I'm going to go to Y, and then this click this one, and it will paste them. At the moment it's just going to do strange little diagonal because they're completely aligned, they're doing exactly the same thing. But if I come down here to phase and just randomly put that somewhere else, the X and the Y, if I bring them both up, are doing different things. And now I'll go to Z, paste that in there, and we'll go the other way on the phase this time. And you may want to tweak the strength, obviously. You can even play around with the scale to slow it down or speed it up. And we can then do the same with the other claws. And if you think the strength is a bit too high, you can obviously turn it down a little bit. So that's animated our claw, and we'll just do the material now. Before I start that, I'm just going to add a lamp into the scene, and we'll put an area light on just above him. We'll set the background to black, and I did this in EV, so we'll turn on screen space reflections, and we'll turn our lamp up quite a bit. We'll turn on contact shadows, and under shadows we'll turn on soft shadows. And I'll add another lamp, which will be just a point lamp, but very bright. And then we'll create a material, and we will copy that material to selected. So we'll come under the shader editor, and we'll just stop the animation for a bit, and we'll set the base color. I just chose a strange little sort of pink color, pinky yellow color, and we're going to set the subsurface to say about 0.65. That's what I found worked for me. What this means is some light will enter into the object, and as you can see it gets light translucent effect to the surface. So that's already quite interesting, but I wanted to have an effect that looked like capillaries and arteries underneath the surface, so I did a bit more than that. So just while we're developing it, I'm going to turn the subsurface off again, and I'm going to add a color mix node. I'm going to put bright red on one side and then a very dark red on the other, and that will be connected into the subsurface color, but for the moment I'm just going to put it on the base color so that it'll basically change the color of the surface so we can see what we're doing. And there it is. Next I'm going to add the usual color ramp. I had it set to B-spline, take the color output into the factor of the mix node, and I actually swapped these over. You can play around with it to see what works, and had the node points up somewhere around there. I'll give you an overview of the whole thing in a moment. Now I'm going to add texture, which is a noise texture, leaving a little space for a reason. Take the factor of that into the color ramp. I used 4D, which just gives you some extra parameters to play with, and an initial scale of about 7. Now in order to see what's going on here, turn the subsurface off completely. There you can see something starting to happen now, and we can play around with the color ramp to sort of select for the noise. Now I haven't unwrapped this obviously at the moment, but what we can do is add an input which is a texture coordinate, and we can try some different texture coordinates rather than unwrapping. And I quite like that one, so I've just used object there. Now to make things easy, I'm going to add an input which is a value input. Just allows you to put a number into here. I'm going to put 7 in there, and I'm going to take that down to the scale. I'm going to have another value input, which I'm going to have 100 in, and I'm going to put that into detail. We can just play. So you can see at the moment we've got this sort of patchy effect on the surface. I'm now going to duplicate that noise texture, and I'm going to take scale from there to there and detail from there to there. So they've both got the same values coming in. Just having these little value inputs just means I only have to change one, I haven't got to run between the two. So essentially, both of these noise textures are creating the same pattern, once you take, of course, the texture coordinate to both of them. Just created a little node there just to tidy that up. So if I swap back to the other one, you can see it's exactly the same. What I want to do now is make this one slightly different, and I'll do that by this W input. That's why I used the 4D node, but only very slightly different. So I'm going to go for 0.005. Very, very subtle difference that isn't immediately obvious. I'm going to add a color invert node, and then I'm going to add another color mix node. This time we're mixing these two noise inputs, and we're going to set this to difference and the factor up at 1. We then just need to adjust this till we get the sort of thing we're looking for. So you can see it's the edges that are being selected for now. And the tighter you go here, the thinner those capillaries, whatever they are, will appear to be. So that's created that, and obviously it moves around with the object. Later on, you can just convert these to meshes and then you can unwrap them and they won't move around this way. So what we can now do is take this out of here and put it into the subsurface color and put subsurface up to 0.65 again. And you can swap these over in order to get dark capillaries rather than light ones I just had. And then finally, I added another noise texture. Just set this one to 3D, add vector node, which is a bump node. Take the factor into the height on the bump node. I set the scale to about 10, the detail at maximum, and the strength to about 0.175. And then that goes into the normal input. You can see we've got a bit more surface texture now. And then turn the roughness down a little bit, make it a bit shinier, and perhaps add a bit more color there. And that's all there is to creating this little creature. And as I said, there'll be a link on the screen now for you to go to my geometry node tutorial to see how you can distribute that. The only difference will be that you need to distribute collection rather than individual objects. So I will upload the original file that I created for my Patreon supporters, and I hope you found this useful. And if you did, do please click like, leave a comment if there's something that you're interested about or would like to know more about as regards this, and I'll do my best to answer you or create another tutorial. So I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next tutorial. Thanks a lot.